Alabama about to kick off to get things started. On the move from inside his five. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. Linebackers moving, trying to confuse the quarterback. Off the play fake on first down, wants to throw. And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17. When you play at a place like Alabama, you have to live up to the legacy of the Jonathan Allens, the Deron Haynes, the Marcel Darius is when you play on that defensive front.
And the funny thing is, Reese, I can keep going. Quinnen Williams, Will Anderson, like the list goes on and on and on. Just elite level recruiting on the defensive line, on the edge, is how they built this dynasty at Alabama.
They come to the line hoping to get some of that yardage back from the 17. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there. Receivers work tirelessly tapping that toe along the sideline, and it just looks so natural for him.
Yeah, it can't just be pat and go all the time, right? Reese just jogging down the field, ball hits you right in stride. You got to be able to make awkward body catches and do it getting your feet in bounds. That was sweet.
Smith dropping the pass. And the ball is picked off. And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception.
And that's kind of a double whammy for this offense, because on their opening drive, not only did they turn it over with the interception, but they've now set their defense up in a really tough spot deep in their own end.
Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Here we go. They'll crank up this drive with the pass. Caught in the backfield, it's Johnson. And he'll make his way out of bounds after the solid pickup.
Yeah, and you see running backs in today's football, they play wide receiver basically for you, but you got to find a guy that you can throw it to, and you know he's going to catch the ball consistently.
From the gun, the running back has it. And he'll be taken down, but he does have enough for the first down.
And listen, the offensive line has to do their job, but a really good job by the running back, understanding where his hole is. Go hit it, get the first down, don't mess around. Nice job following his hole, getting positive yards.
He's looking to throw it. Got rid of it quickly, but it's incomplete. Operating in the red zone here on second down. Misfired on the last play, they'll go back to the air. Missed his receiver there. It's incomplete. Boy, they'd love to pick up this conversion and go to work with a first and goal. Trying to move the sticks on third down through the air. Almost intercepted in the end zone, and what a red zone stop that would have been. It'll be fourth down. And it looks as if they've buzzed down. Replay wants to have another peek at that last play. So the officials take a closer look, and the replay booth will overturn the call.
Got it.
Three straight misfires has left them staring at fourth and 10, but they'll try it again.
Clear. Come on.
He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. That's a fly. And it's incomplete, a missed opportunity. Incomplete.
That is great job by this defense, coming up big on fourth down when it matters the most. You could tell they were dialed in. They knew they were going to throw the football. The defense was locked in on the quarterback. Great job defending the pass, forcing the incompletion on fourth down.
Notre Dame has the ball and ready to get moving. And he will be sacked at the 6-yard line.
And a great job by the defense, dropping in zone coverage, all eyes on the quarterback, taking away the options, and then finally the pass rush gets home, gets him on the ground.
And now they have enhanced their degree of difficulty on second and long from the 6. Using his legs, it's Thomas. And they try to run inside, and there is nowhere to go.
Well, this is a defense that we know takes tons of pride stopping the run. That's where it all starts and ends with them, and you saw a great effort on that last play.
Not exactly the ideal situation for this offense. Third and long, backed up inside their 20. Hand off from the shotgun. And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down. Boy, if they don't convert this fourth down, there will be questions to be answered. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Complete out of the backfield. How about that defense rising up and stopping him short on fourth down? On first and goal, let's see if Alabama can get it in the end zone. They'll try to get it in with the run. And they try the middle of this defense, and that is not happening. And the D deny them on second and goal. He's looking to throw. Quarterback doing what he does best. He can move. That pass is incomplete, and they're probably fortunate that it wasn't knocked free for a fumble. Third and goal coming up here. From the gun, wants to pass. Got it in the middle. It's Glovelet.
Man, we're seeing the tight end used more and more in the passing game. You see him moving inside. You see him moving outside. You see him moving in the box to block people. So here they put him in the slot and just have a nice little pitch and catch session.
Fourth and goal from the 3, and the offense will stay up. Touchdown, Alabama! And they'll put that scoreboard operator to work and put 6 on the board.
What a nice start for this offense. The throw game getting working, getting the touchdown pass. This quarterback getting a little bit of confidence. This passing game getting in a rhythm. Nice start for this offense.
Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll start the return inside his 5. And good work by the coverage team to knock down the return man. Here come the Irish, back on offense. Coming out on first down with the play fake. That's caught, it's Lacy. Now they've got a little room to work with. They're out to the 28 with a first down. The Irish have always been built on the run, but timely completions are important, like the great Tom Clements back in the day or John Hewitt.
Got to be clutch, right? Got to be balanced and got to find those moments where you can thrive. It's always a system, it seems like, at Notre Dame where it's been built around the run game and it's built around physicality, but they got to get that element of balance to really take off and get to that next level.
Now on first down from the 28. They'll put the tight end in motion. Now the play fake. Trying to get to it. And he can't escape, and down he goes.
Well, I think one of the biggest reasons why this team is finding themselves in a hole here in the first half is this has been a sack party. They can't keep the defense off of their quarterback. They haven't been able to get the ball deep down the field, throwing it with the consistency they want, because they can't keep their quarterback standing up straight.
Gave up the sack on first down. Now it's second and 11. Smith wants to throw. Floats it out in space. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there, and still a little ground to cover to pick up the first. Well, he comes up with the reception, but not a lot of room to run after that.
Yeah, and I like the QB doing this. I mean, I'm going to find ways to give him the football and see if he can make a miss. And I'm going to bet most of the time that my guy is a little bit more athletic than that defensive guy. Defense won this battle, but I like trying to give this guy the ball in space.
Well, we know this guy is special. And because of that, his quarterback is looking to him on critical down and distances. There on that third down, there was no question. It wouldn't have mattered if he was single covered, double covered, man, zone. That's where he was going with it. And the big-time playmaker outside picks up the first.
Looking to go up top on first down. Right down the middle. And it's intercepted. A turnover for the defense.
This is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. Two interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision here.
Trying to start the drive with a pass. Got him downfield. And he slipped through the crowd, and he'll house it. Touchdown tie!
And that's his second receiving touchdown of the game. My man is just finding pay dirt. Tell you what, these are the kind of guys that you continue to feature throughout a game when he can do this kind of damage after he catches the football.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point pushes the lead to 14. That's the kind of drive everybody loves. OC quarterback, one snap, put it in the end zone. They got the late touchdown on the board, now about to kick it away and hoping the defense can keep. Sort of lost it in the sun and muffed it. Here he comes from inside his own five. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. David, maybe to swing the momentum in their favor.
Dang right. There's no time to be conservative. We're a little bit down. Listen, I just think this.
And he throws his third pick of the day. His head has to be spinning. And he's going to take it all the way back. Touchdown, Crimson Tide. Look, a lot of time left. There's a little bit of distance right now being put on the scoreboard.
There is, but it's so awesome when you're a defense and you study all week about what's coming and what routes to be ready for, and then you jump the route and you make the plays and you just go get in that end zone. It is so beautiful.
And the extra point was good as they finished the drive. They got the touchdown, now going to put it in the hands of their defense to finish off this half. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Slips through the line. Got a little room. Can they catch him? He is headed to the sideline with a little bounce in his step after scoring on that kick return.
And he should have some bounce in his step. How about the effort, weaving in and out, covering all that space, great blocking on the play, and he does the rest. You don't put guys back deep that can't roll. And you could see when he got in the open field, he rolled out.
And after the extra point, they're now down 21-7. You get a return like that, and it can't just be the guy with the ball who's right. Everybody has to do a job, and they did that in brilliant fashion on that one. And he takes this from inside the five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Just enough time for one final play in this half. From the shotgun, the inside give. And he's taken down after a short gain, and that'll do it for us here in the first half.
That's the end of the first half. With the score, Alabama 21, Notre Dame 7.
Ready to go here in the second half, and Notre Dame will kick it away. Oh, right through his fingers, he muffed it. He'll bring it back from inside the 15. And they'll haul down the returner to start us on the next drive. Here comes that Alabama offense. He'll start the third quarter with the run. That may not look like a huge run, but they'll take it as it gets him up to the 24.
I know it's sexy to throw the football, but if you can pound it away and get these kind of gains, they will just add up, wear the defense down, get first downs, and ultimately get some points.
Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry.
Well, the offensive line had everybody blocked except the defensive end. He was able to sneak into the backfield and get the tackle for loss.
So third and short from inside the 20. You convert here, and this drive takes on a different complexion. The ball is out behind the line. Oh, and he gets the ball back. Lucky to do so. Guess it could have been worse.
Woo. Deep breath, right? Man, you fumble that thing, you cough it up, you're like, oh, I really appreciate you, brother. I can't tell you how much I thank you, because the coaches would have been all over me, but big-time break for the offense.
On fourth down, they'll try to throw it. Oh, he's got a chance. He's off to the races. At the 30. The 10. And he just kept running, and he ran away from the crowd, and he'll take it in. Touchdown!
Well, the quarterback does a great job with his decision-making. He found the matchup he wanted one-on-one. His tight end's able to stretch the field. He makes the catch, and he does the rest of the work himself, running it into the end zone.
And he makes the extra point. They'll decline the penalty here, and the result of the play stands. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. On the run from inside his own five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. On first down, here comes this offense. Linebackers trying to create some confusion. Off the play fake on first down. Got his man to the left. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down. Big play for the Irish there, reminiscent of a Tim Brown or Rocket Ismail.
Yeah, I'm glad you used a reference in the last 30 years, Reese. You know, just trying to find playmakers at Notre Dame, and Michael Mayer, obviously, in the recent years, was a guy that you could really, really depend on. Trying to find those golden Tates, those elite players out wide, is something they've been missing over the last several years.
They're trying to get to it. That one never had a chance. Incomplete. The
Alabama's quarterback is really struggling in this game with decisions and also accuracy. He's already been picked off multiple times, and that time, that was a bad underthrow. He's lucky that one wasn't picked off.
The incompletion leads to second and 10. Smith dropping the pass. Pressure coming. That pass is incomplete, and they might be fortunate. It wasn't knocked free for a fumble. It'll be third down.
They've already got a bunch of sacks on them today and another quarterback pressure. This offense has to try to find a way to get the ball out a little bit quicker, to protect their quarterback a little bit more. Whether it's screens, whether it's draws, whether it's rolling your quarterback, something has to change for this offense to protect their quarterback a little bit better.
Third down, and this offense is already in a world of trouble. They could really use a conversion, not to mention multiple scores. Fires to the right. Pulls it in. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
Well, how about the offense setting that play up? We've seen earlier in the game a couple shorter throws. They're just trying to suck those safeties closer to the line of scrimmage, anticipating that they would get an opportunity to take a shot. They called the perfect play at the perfect time right there.
Notre Dame ready to go back to work with another first down. He's gonna pass. Makes his connection. Smashes through. And they finally haul him down, but not before the good catch and run. He's starting to get in touch with his inner Joe Montana as the Irish are moving the ball up top.
And I think that's always the question with the Irish every year is who's gonna play quarterback? We know their brand and we know who they are, but are they gonna get ballers at that position? Are they gonna get a great Ian Book, a great Brady Quinn? That's the next step. And if they find that guy, Notre Dame can do everything they want to do and be great in college football.
Pulls it in. It's Clemens. They'll get it down to the 8-yard line on that throw and catch, and the defense is backed up against the wall.
Slants against man. That wide receiver has to win right now. Right now at the line of scrimmage against that DB playing man coverage. Quarterback timing with the wide receiver. Put it on the money. Wide receiver's probably still going to get hit too and got to hold on to that thing.
Smith wants to throw. Looking for the score. Snagged in the end zone. Touchdown Notre Dame. Got to start cutting into this lead somewhere. Now the question, will they have enough time?
But that's step one. You got to get that first score. You got to get back in the ball game and get some of that momentum back on your side. You still got more work to do, but step one accomplished.
And with the extra point, they trail by two touchdowns, 28-14. They've got it down to a two-touchdown deficit, trailing by 14 and about to kick it away. And this is caught inside the 30, and here he comes. Nice return there, and he'll be dragged down at the 34. The Tide offense rolls onto the field. David, they'd love to do what they did last time and put this one in the end zone.
You ain't lying. They did a great job. The offense was clicking. Everything went well. Palmer, they executed and got the touchdown.
And they really were in a nice rhythm as well. I'd love to see that here on the next drive, too. Just keep doing what you're doing. Everything seems to be working, and you seem to have this defense on their heels.
We'll start the quarter offense about to snap it on second down. 42 Spider. They'll keep it on the ground to keep this clock moving. And he's tripped up, but not before picking up the first down.
Well, it's an offense that prides himself on being physical. No mystery there. You need 1 yard, turn around, hand it off, let him go to work.
They're getting this guy lathered up. Continuing to turn and move it forward, and they're closing in on midfield. It's down at the 48. Quick timeout call by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. Looking for a physical attack from the gun. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Big third down for this defense. Listen, you've got to get the ball back. You know what they're doing. They're trying to run the football, but we need the clock to be on our side so our offense has some time. Got to make us.
And it's intercepted, maybe breathing a little life into this team. And they capitalized not only on the pick, but on the great return to improve this field position.
This is frustrating. You know, you're an offense. You're in a great position. You're up by two scores. All you do is take care of the football. Premium, taking care of the football. We're trying to run some clock. We're trying to get out of here with a W. Turning the football over is the worst thing you could possibly do.
Feeling some heat. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
And the quarterback gets hit again. We already know this defense has gotten home to him multiple times in this game. So here you are. You're trailing in the game. Defense knows you're going to throw it. They're pinning their ears back. You can't feel very confident right now if you're the play caller, certainly if you're the quarterback, that you're going to have time to throw.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. Smith dropping to pass. And that pressure just engulfed him. A sack for this defense. 2 minutes now left in this one, and time is running short if they want to find a way to pull this one out. Ball is at the 41 as this defense tries to force the punt on third and long. He's looking downfield to throw. Not in lockstep there with the receiver.
After that incompletion, fourth and long now on your own side of the field, you're trailing in the fourth quarter. What's your go-to play call here in the passing game? Where is the matchup that you trust in to come up with a big one to give yourself a chance to stay alive and win this game?
Coach has no choice here. The offense has to stay on the field, down multiple possessions this late. Fourth down attempt coming. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. And it's picked off for the fourth time today. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
And that's a really good job by the defense, understanding the situation of football. It's fourth down. It's late in the game. You got a multi-possession lead. Take away all the deep stuff. Make them force the football into coverage. They do, and they stamp this game.
Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. No reason to do anything here except keep it on the ground on second and five. Just feeds the running back. And a decent gain there before the defense makes a stop.
I think one of the hardest things to do is stick to the run when it's not working. But it's those runs right there that are the reason why you have to do it, right? You can't get too one-dimensional. Keep slipping those runs in there. Keep getting a little bit of positive yards. Next thing you know, you'll look up and you might break one of those after you got them a little bit tired.
This offense believes you are given four downs for a reason. You've got to use all of them. 2 for 3 so far today. Finds his man and they convert. He steps out of bounds, but he's got a first down on the play. A new set of downs after the completion. Looking to move it through the air. Can't find his man as he took a shot trying to deliver that football, and it'll be second down. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. On second down, they'll take to the air. Unleashes one deep. Just a bit of a misfire there as they can't make the connection. They're close enough for a makeable field goal from the 26, but they'd love to convert this third and long. Looking to throw it again. He'll take a shot. Oh, and he dropped it. He had a touchdown right in his hands and couldn't hang on. It'll be fourth down. No sign of the punt team as they will go for it and try to move those chains. Throws to the wideout. What a job to lay out and make the catch.
That's a great example of the receiver knowing exactly where the first down marker is. He got the depth he needed to get, so once he was able to make the catch, he already knew he had it. Now, a fresh set of downs.
Now he's going to glide away from pressure. He caught it! He's down at the one, and they almost had the touchdown pass on that one. The defense calls the timeout, and that's their last one of the half. He wants to throw here on second down. And it's caught! Touchdown, Alabama!
And this offense continuing to put up points. This game's out of reach. You know you're going to win, but still throwing the football, still finding that connection. I imagine there'll be some salty handshakes at the end of this game.
About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. On the move from inside his five. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. Well, you don't see this very often, so much for fighting till the bitter end as they will concede defeat. Not a lot of productivity on that last play. They'll try it again on second and long from the 23. And they'll take a knee. We sensed a great deal of confidence, almost a smugness from this coaching staff. And these guys on the field, it's as if they knew they were going to win.
Yeah, playing with a bit of a chip on their shoulder, and I think they really felt like they had a real good game plan offensively and defensively coming into this one, David. There were some matchups on the field they thought they could exploit. We saw that happen.
No doubt. Good job by this coaching staff, understanding who's out there to make plays, feeding them the football, offense, defense, special teams, all working together to get the W.
So that's going to do it for us. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis.